11 months ago, I developed a video how to create multiple dependent drop-down list in Google Sheet. Many people like the video, but we are facing two limitations. For example, if I insert a row in between the data sheet, everything stops working. If I select, let's say, Africa, it will show me the wrong country. So this is one limitation. I'm just hitting Ctrl Z to back to original view. And now, for example, if I delete a row, everything stops working again. So these are two main limitations people facing a problem. Recently, Google added a table feature within a Google Sheet just like an Excel. And now I developed the same dependent dropdown with the same option just to show you. Now if I click here and insert a new row, everything works perfect. Even if I click and delete the rows, everything will work fine. If I select Africa, it will only show me the country related to Africa based on our drop-down table. If I click here and simply select South America, it will only show me the country related to South America as well as the city. So we have overcome the issue with new table feature. But how we create this dependent drop-down in table, I will show you each and everything in this video. Consider I have the blank data sheet and I have the drop-down table list. The first thing we need to insert a table, click on insert and here you can see tables. Click on this one. I want to insert a blank table and simply close this window. In this case, I only need 4 columns. So I will simply remove the other column, delete table column, click here and simply delete table column. Now I will rename this column properly. Now I will click on this down arrow and here you can see edit column type. This is a date column, so I will simply select the date. Next I will click on continents, edit type, and in this case I want drop down. Now here you can see a window will be appear. I will simply click drop down from a range, select data range, click here. Click on drop down table and simply click A to drag the mouse down and simply remove the end reference, hit OK and done. Now if I click on the drop down, it will show me all of the unique continent. The next thing, we need to build the drop down for country and city, but first we need to build two helper sheet. I will click on this plus button and we need to rename this sheet, let's say second level. We need another sheet and I will simply rename those sheet, let's say third level. Now I will click on second level sheet, click on A to C, simply type equal, click on input data sheet. In this case, I will select the entire continent column and in the formula bar, you can see table 1 continent. And now simply type Ctrl Shift Enter, it will apply array formula and simply hit Enter. Now we need to filter out the country based on our selected continent. Click on B to cell, simply type equal filter, open parenthesis. Click on drop down table. In this case, I want to filter out the entire country column. So I will select the entire country column, hit comma. Whenever the continent equal to, I will click on second level sheet again. And simply click on A to seal, close parenthesis, hit enter. And now it will filter out all of the matching country based on selected continent. But in this list, we have also a duplicate entry. So I will apply a unique function. Open parenthesis and simply close parenthesis, hit enter. The next thing, we need to transpose this list from column to rows. So there are two functions. Recently, Google Sheet announced to column and to row function. So I will simply write to row function, open parenthesis, and I will leave the other parameter. Of course, these other parameters are very useful. I will simply close parenthesis, hit enter, and this will transpose my data into rows. But I don't want to drag and drop this function again and again if I have more data set. So I will simply improve the B2 formula a little bit more, and I will simply type by row function, open parenthesis, what is the range? In this case, I will click on A to drag the mouse down and simply remove the end reference, hit comma. And now I will type lambda function, open parenthesis, what is the name for the selected range? In this case, I will simply write x, hit comma, and what is the formula or expression? In this case, this whole is my formula or expression. But instead of A2, I will simply type x, and what is x? All of column A values. Now this function will loop row by row, apply the filter function and get the result in multiple columns. If I simply hit enter, you can see we have multiple results, but we have a single formula. Now if I go to my input sheet and simply select the other continent, let's say North America, and go to second level sheet again, everything automatically update. Now I will go to input data sheet again. We need to insert drop down on country column. I will simply click on down arrow button. Here you can see edit column type. In this case, I will select drop down. And for the criteria, I will click drop down from a range. Click here, select data range, and now click on second level sheet, click on B2, drag the mouse to the right side. In this case, I will remove the if because I want to assign the full row. The most important thing, you must need type equal sign, otherwise this method will not work. I will simply hit OK and simply hit done button. Now if I click on column B dropdown, it will show me all of the related country. Now I will build the same formula for third level. I will click on third level sheet, click on A2 cell, simply type equal, click on input sheet, click on C2, drag the mouse down, and you can see table 1 country. If I simply hit enter, it will show me only the one entry. And if I simply click here and type control shift enter, it will apply array formula. And now I will simply hit enter, it will show me all of the selected option. The next thing, I will click on B2 cell, simply type equal, and now I will build same filter function. Open parenthesis, what is the range? Click on drop down table. In this case, I will assign whole column C, hit comma. For the condition, I will select the entire column B, type equal, click on third level sheet, click on A2, simply close parenthesis, hit enter. And now it will filter out all of the matching city. Of course, in this case, we have only one matching city, but for the safety purpose, I will simply type unique function. Just to make our list shorter, of course, the dropdown automatically ignore the duplicate entry. Hit enter, and now we need to transpose this list. I will simply type to row function, open parenthesis, and simply close parenthesis. The next thing, I don't want to drag and drop this function again and again. Look at Japan, we have three matching cities. So I will delete all of my formula and click on B2 cell. We need to build by row function. Simply type by row, open parenthesis, what is the array? Click on A2, drag the mouse down. In this case, I will remove the end number. We want to assign full column, hit comma. And now I will type lambda, open parenthesis, for the name, in this case, I will write x. You can define any name you like, hit comma. For the formula expression, this whole is our function, but instead of A2, I will simply write x. Now what is x? X is actually the whole column A value. Now this function again loop row by row, apply the filter function, then unique function, and give us the result. Now if I simply hit enter, everything dynamically update. Now I will click on input sheet, click on city column. We want to change the type to drop down. For the criteria, I will click drop down from a range, select data range, click here, click on third level sheet, click on B2, drag the mouse to the right side. In this case, I will remove the E, and you must type equal sign, otherwise this method will not work. Click OK, and you must need hit done button. Now if I click on city column, it will show me all of the related city. If I change Japan to, let's say, China, it will only show me city related to China. Now if I click here, insert a new row, and now if I click on country list, it will always show me the correct country. If I select, let's say, any other continent, it will only show me the matching country based on our drop-down table. Even if I delete the row in between, everything will properly work. I hope you learned something useful and enjoyed this video. Please share this video as much as possible, because many people are facing this problem. I see Stack Overflow, many other sites, and this new table feature will save a lot of our time. I hope you enjoyed the video. Thank you so much.